Hi, and welcome to In Bed with Lainey, where we get stripped down to our raw, authentic selves to get a little comfortably uncomfortable and talk about sensuality. And today, I'm so lucky to get to be in bed with Bobby. Bobby, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I am 38 years old. I live in San Diego, and I'm single and never been married. And in the last year, I've done a lot of pondering and work and discovery as to why.
What have you come up with?
I've realized that a big part of it was that I'd carried a bit of a victim mentality.
And what does that look like?
When things didn't, say, work out, I had the mentality that it was other people's fault. Or if someone hurt me or betrayed me, I harped on that rather than as to where it was that I showed up. It's, you know, I come from an athletic background where it's all about putting the work in and having accountability and ownership for your results. And to have realized that I had taken a victim mentality in other aspects of my life, it was actually a very embarrassing and humiliating thing for me internally to realize. Just because we've been victims at times in our life, it doesn't give you the right to live your life and act as a victim. Big breakthrough I had involved vulnerability, which as I understand it, goes hand in hand with sexuality. There's strength in vulnerability. And as I learned about that, it empowered me to take that risk and open up and be more vulnerable with people. To take that risk, to be brave, and reveal something about yourself. But from a position of strength and confidence. And when you do that, and I think when it's done right, and with a kind-hearted person, they feel safe and empowered to do the same as well.
Where do you think vulnerability comes into dating, and what is this mass issue that people have with vulnerability and allowing it into their sensual lives?
Fear.
One word. Fear.
Everybody's had their heart broken. Whether it's someone back in grade school, junior high, or in your adult life recently. And every time someone hurts you, every time someone lets you down, it hardens you. It, whether you admit it or not, we build walls up, and unfortunately, pass that judgment on to the next person.
What's sensually sexy for you?
For me, is connection, energy, unspoken communication, reading each other, knowing what the other wants. She just knows. You don't need to say anything. But there's a lot of dialogue going on right there.
Yeah.
But no words are spoken.
Yeah.
Because that doesn't happen off a hookup.
Thank Bobby for getting raw and vulnerable and real with us and sharing what sensuality means to him.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you for joining us, and see you next time.